Thank you for joining the VeEX Technical Training Series. The topic for this session is testing throughput speeds. Now let's go ahead and get started. I'm going to cover both the RF throughput using the cable modem and also the Ethernet network testing using that Ethernet port on the top of the CX310. But first, let's open up the cable modem. I'm going to select cable modem. I'm already set up on channel 58. I'm going to do a connect. Okay, the cable modem is now locked and it is online. Now this modem is not provisioned, so I won't be able to reach the throughput server, the Ookla server, but I'm going to show you the setup, but then I'm going to actually go to the Ookla server when I go into the Ethernet mode, which the modes looked pretty much identical. So the first thing I want to do is select IP tools. Now, just a few things that you want to be aware of. First of all, where it says stream numbers, look at your stream numbers as, let's say you have a network with a customer, they're typically going to have one stream that is provided to that cable modem. Now, what we have the ability to do is to have the CMTS provide us multiple streams. So we're able to test the throughput capacity of the network. So you kind of look at it as if I have four laptops in a sense, and it's on different networks, and this CMTS is sending my particular cable modem, each one of them, whatever the throughput speed. Now I can look at the combined throughput speed, and I can determine what the total network speed is capable of. Then you have your test mode. We want to keep that the way that it is, but where it has your provider, you want to set your provider at Charter. VTest server. You want to select the server that is closest to you. In my case, I'm going to use Columbus 03. Once everything is set up properly, all that you have to do is press start. Now I'm going to show you what that screen looks like when you press the start in Ethernet tools. I'm going to close out of here, but this is the setup. This is the setup for doing your cable modem Ethernet. Your cable modem testing. So now I'm going to go to the Ethernet. So I'm going to select more from my home screen and Ethernet tools. Now, in order for me to go online, I have to have an IP address. So I'm going to select IP. Now, typically inside of a house or at a residence, you're usually going to use DHCP, which DHCP is dynamic. It simply will request an IP address. Or if this was a business services type of customer, you could do static. In my case, DHCP. Also ensure that DHCP renewal says enable. Once everything is set the way that it needs to be, select your arrow at the upper right-hand corner and connect. I now have an IP address assigned So I want to go to VTest. Now at this point here, this is what this is the same point that we were at when we were on the cable modem page. So remember what we what I was showing you in the cable modem, this is the same process that you would do. So what I'm going to do, remember, you want to select the provider. And in my case, I'm going to select Charter, which is on page 3. Now I need to select the server that I want to test to. Now I'm in Indianapolis, so I want to test to Ohio. So I'm going to select Columbus, Ohio 3. Columbus 03. Once everything is set up, start. It's going to first give a series of pings. The same thing happens with the cable modem. It's going to be 10 pings. Once the 10 pings are finished, this once the purpose of the ping, we want to make sure that that server is there before we start sending packets. And as we can see that it's now downloading, the question comes up sometimes, do I use the max rate, the average rate, or the current? Which one do I want to use? What I usually answer in that particular, when that question is asked to me, is that the max is the maximum amount of packets or throughput that I'm able to get. Keep in mind that your customers, when you're providing the service, it's provided to them as best effort. So the customer could be paying for 300 megabits per second, but there's no, it's not a guaranteed service that it's going to be 300 megabits per second. Sometimes it could be 200. Sometimes it could be more. Sometimes it could be less. So that's what I want to look at. So in this particular case, my max is the maximum amount that's going through. Then I have the average. The average is more of what the customer is going to feel like. This is what it feels like to them. So it's showing that 375 megabits per second is, there were packets that were bursting through at that speed. However, the average is at 369. So that's where it's all averaging at. So to answer the question would be, is that if I'm showing the customer, I'm going to say 375 megabits per second. That's our max. But now from a troubleshooting standpoint, I'm looking at my average because that's what the customer, that's the way that the customer is going to feel, or that's the way that the throughputs are going to feel like, the average. Now, one thing that is different on the Ethernet VTest opposed to the cable modem is the line rate and data rate on two pages. Now, the difference between line rate and data rate, your line rate is, kind of look at the line rate as your pipe. The pipe is your line rate. But then your data rate is that pipe minus overhead. So that's for the switching, routing, all of that kind of good stuff on your network. That's your data rate. Now, in the scenario here, I said that I'm in Indianapolis, but I was reaching out to Columbus, Ohio in order to send the packets. But let's say if I want to test something that's a little closer to me, I can do that by just selecting Setup. And instead of using VX Manage, let's change that. Let's make that Ookla Netgauge. I'm going to keep it on auto for right now. Start. Same type of thing, but if you look at the upper left, you see the server ID, it's cycling through different numbers. So what it's doing is it's reaching out to local Ookla servers and it's finding the one that has the best connection, and that's the one that it's going to direct me to. And that's what it's doing now. It's directing me to server ID 5115. You can see my download speeds. And then after the download is finished, it goes to the upload. So very similar to what you were looking at first when you were using the VeEX managed servers, because we have a link that's directing it to the particular server that's on there. But in this case, you're actually getting something a little more local. Now, there's yet another way that you can do this. So let's say that we have multiple Ookla servers that's nearby where I'm at. So I can go into setup. I'm just going to press stop. I'm going to go into the setup. And instead of auto, let's try manual. Select manual. Update is done. I'm going to do OK. So now the same list of servers that were cycling through there when it was trying to find the best one, now by me selecting the server ID, I can manually select the servers that I want. Right now, this is showing that it's Indianapolis and it's going to AT&T. But now let's see if I select this down arrow here. I have multiple pages, quite a few servers. I'm just going to pick one at random. Now, in this case, instead of it going to AT&T, it's in Greenfield, and it's going to 9-Star Connect. So now I'll be testing directly to that particular location. So I could test there each time if I wanted to. And then last but not least, let's back out of here. And let's go, instead of going the Ookla Netgauge, I'm going to select that. And I'm going to select manual here. So I'll select manual. Now let's say if there's an Ookla server that you're wanting to test to. There's a particular server that maybe there's one that's in your hub or your head in, and it's set up with Ookla that you want to test to that particular one. You can do that. All that you want to do is put in the IP address of that particular server. Once you set all of that up, then you can test directly to it. But now let's say if you want to test to that server each time, then you can add it to the server list by selecting right now, it says none. I'm going to select that. And I'm going to do save as new. And I'm going to call this home. And apply. So now this is added to the server list. So what I could do is, the next time when I come in to get ready to do a speed test, I can select server mode, user managed, because this is a server that I set up. And now here's my available server list. And I can have multiple servers in here. Maybe there's one that I want to have that's right here at the head end where I'm at. But then maybe I have a head end on the other side of town, or maybe the next town over that I want to test to there just to kind of compare the two. Then I could set up multiple different servers. Once that's all set up the way that you want, you do the same thing. You just press start. Once you select start, then it'll go through and it'll start measuring your throughput speeds. Hopefully this was helpful, and I do appreciate you joining in. There is information on the screen if you do want to contact VeEX. Take care.